Welcome to my channel. I'm Zhang Jingxu. Let's look at the power 45 in chapter 14. Chapter 14 is about oscillations. Now we have a simple pendulum oscillations. It is amplitude is given. And then we also know its angular velocity is 2 pi over t, right? And then we need to find what fraction of time does it spend between this range. So for pendulum oscillations, if we look at the horizontal x, and its motion can be described in this function. Do you agree? Yes, it's a simple harmonic motion. And also, there is omega is 2 pi over t, and why we choose cosine? Because we think it starts at their maximum theta. Now we can see this x is L times theta. This is L times theta. And amplitude is L times theta max. In this way, we can get the function for the theta, right? For the angle theta. And this angle theta changes with time t in this function. Now, first one, when the theta 1 is a 5 degree, so when theta 1 is a 5 degree, it's there. So this is a 5 degree. So this is a maximum to the 5 degree. So it moves to 5 degree there. So this is a 5 degree. Now, how much time take for T1 from there to there? We can input the theta 1 inside, right? And then we can get the T1 is this value. Now, from the 5 degree to the balanced point, the theta is 0, so we get T2. Sorry, this is T2. And input the theta 2 equal to 0, and then we get the time T. Of course, from the amplitude to the balance point is 1/4 of T. Now, in this part, if we use the 1/4 of T minus T over 6, is the time for this fraction. Do you agree? And then because this is a mirror symmetry, so it from there moves to this position, agree? And then moves back. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4 times for this fraction, agree? Do you understand why there is 4? Because this is 4 times of, see, from 5 degree to 0, 0 to negative 5, negative 5 to 0, 0 to 5, just 4 times of this period. Of this time duration. And then we can find the answer there. Thank you.